Tenth session on basic electrical engineering, unit 1, introduction, lecture 2. We'll see what is capacitance and inductance parameter. Now let's coming to capacitance parameter. A capacitor is a passive element designed to store energy in its electric field. Capacitance is generally denoted by C. As you can see, there are two plates separated by a small distance. Therefore, a capacitor consists of two conducting plates separated by a small distance, and an insulator or a dielectric is present between the plates. Let's see what is capacitance definition. Capacitance is the ratio of charge on a plate of a capacitor to potential difference between the two plates, and the units of capacitance are farads. As you can see, a voltage that is applied to a capacitor, a charge gets accumulated on the plates. The charge is given by Q is equal to C into V, where Q is the charge, C is the capacitance, and also C is equal to epsilon A by D, where epsilon is the permittivity of the dielectric material between the plates, A is the area of each plate, and D is the distance between the plates. And the unit of capacitance as discussed is farad, and it's sometimes also given in picofarad, nanofarad and microfarad. As a farad is a very large unit, in many of the cases we use picofarad, nanofarad, microfarad, even in your laboratories. So picofarad is 10 power minus 12 farads, and nanofarad is 10 power minus 9 farads, and microfarad is 10 power minus 6 farads. If current is flowing into positive terminal of capacitance, charging and discharging takes place. I is positive when the capacitor is charging, and current will be negative in the negative opposite direction when it is discharging. The current voltage relationship of a capacitor according to the above convention is I is equal to C dV by dt, or V is equal to 1 by C integral I dt. Plus, if it is previously charged, a initial charge that is present or the potential present on the capacitor is V of T naught. If the initial condition is assumed to be zero, that is, if the capacitor is uncharged capacitor, then V of T naught value will be equal to zero. The energy stored in a capacitor is given by W is equal to half CV square. And how do you get that? W is equal to integral of P dt. We have seen the expression of work done and power in the previous lecture. So integral 0 to T P is given as V into I dt, where I is equal to C dV by dt for capacitor, and that comes out to be on integration we'll get V square by 2. Integral of V dV is V square by 2, and C is a constant with respect to dt, so it is half C V square. So energy stored in a capacitor is half C. Let's take an example. A capacitor having a capacitance of 2 microfarad is charged to a voltage of 1000 volts. Calculate the stored energy in joules. So capacitance is 2 microfarad, voltage is 1000 volts, half CV square if you are using, will get 1 joule of energy stored by the capacitor. Let's consider the equivalent capacitance when the capacitors are connected in series and the capacitors are connected in parallel. How do you find the equivalent capacitance or the total capacitance of the connection? So when capacitors are connected in series, the equivalent capacitance is given by 1 by C equivalent is equal to 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3, and that is C equivalent is equal to C1, C2, C3 by C1, C2 plus C2, C3 plus C1, C3. Its capacitors connected in series. And capacitance, if they are connected in parallel, capacitors are connected in parallel, the sum of the capacitors gives the equivalent capacitance, that is C equivalent is equal to C1 plus C2 plus C3. Let's take a problem on series and parallel capacitance. Let's say C1, C2, C3 are three capacitors connected in series of values 1, 2 and 3 farads, and the equivalent capacitance will be C1, C2, C3 by C1, C2 plus C2, C3 plus C3, C1. So that comes out to be 0.55 farads. Let's take if they are connected in parallel, 1, 2, 3 farads of capacitors are connected in parallel, and the equivalent will be 1 plus 2 plus 3, which is 6 farads. That was all about capacitance and capacitor. And coming to an inductance parameter, inductance is a property and inductor is an element. Do remember that inductance is a property of a material and inductor is a material or an element. So inductance is a property whereby an inductor exhibits opposition to change of current flowing through it, right? So the units of inductance are henries, and V is given by voltage across an inductor is L times di by dt, rate of change of current. The unit of inductance is henry or milli henry and micro henry. We'll use some of these in laboratories, milli and micro henries, while doing some of the experiments in RLC circuits. Milli henry is 10 power minus 3 and micro henry is 10 power minus 6 henries. The current voltage relationship of an inductor is given as I is equal to 1 by L integral V of t dt plus I of t naught. For an initially uncharged inductor, I of t naught value will be 0. So I is equal to 1 by L integral t naught to t V of t dt. Similarly, the power absorbed by an inductor can be, as in case of capacitor, we have given half CV square. It is half LI square here. We can derive this in the same way as we have derived for the capacitor. Let's take an example. Find the inductance of a coil through which flows a current of 0.2 ampere with an energy of 0.15 joules. As you know, current is given as 0.2 amperes and energy is 0.15 joule. So W is equal to half Li square, as you know, energy stored by an inductor. So if you substitute these values, so L will be 7.5 henry. You are finding the value of inductance, because find the inductance of the coil, that was what the question is asked in the example 6. So let's solve how inductance, if they are connected in series and parallel, what is the equivalent inductance and what are the values, and with an example. So let's say series inductance, when inductors are connected in series, the sum of the inductance gives the equivalent inductance, which is same as the resistance. When the resistors are connected in series, the total resistance is the sum of the all the resistances, as simple as that. And L equivalent here, if you say L1, L2, L3, R3 inductors connected in series, then the equivalent inductance will be L1 plus L2 plus L3. Inductors are connected in parallel. So if they are connected in parallel, let's say L1, L2, L3 are connected in parallel, the total inductance will be 1 by L is equal to 1 by L1 plus 1 by L2 plus 1 by L3, or L equivalent is L1, L2, L3 by L1 plus L2 plus L3. So let's take an example, three inductors of value 1 Henry, 2 Henry and 3 Henry are connected in series and parallel. When they are connected in series, like resistors, they get added up, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6 Henry, and if they are in parallel, it is L1, L2, L3 by L1, L2 plus L2, L3 plus L3, L1. So we'll get L equivalent in case of parallel as 0.55 Henry. So these are the current and voltage relationships for resistor, inductor and capacitors. So as we have to study the basic circuit elements, resistor, inductor and capacitance. Unit of resistance, if you see the first row second column, ohms, and voltage current relationship, voltage V is equal to R into I by Ohm's law, and current I is equal to V by R, and power P is equal to V into I is equal to V is equal to I into R, that is I square R. In case of an inductance or an inductor, the units of inductor are henries, second row second column, and voltage is given by V is equal to L di by dt, voltage across an inductor, and current flowing through an inductor is 1 by L integral V dt plus K, and power is equal to V into I or L into di by dt into I. And capacitance, as you know, it is denoted by C and units are farads. Voltage across a capacitor is 1 by C integral I dt plus K2, and current in a capacitor is equal to C dV by dt, and power is equal to CV into dV by dt or V into I. So this is a quiz corresponding to the lecture 2, and we are continuing with the same unit. So I have numbered it as 9 because we have already done 8 questions in first session or first lecture. So what is the equivalent inductance from the given figure? You have to identify whether they are given in series or parallel, and say find the equivalent inductance between the terminals A and B. Similarly, there are two capacitors that are connected in series, and you have to find the equivalent capacitance, because when the capacitors are connected in series, so the equivalent capacitance is C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. It's not C1 plus C2 directly, because it is not same as the resistor. The capacitor and resistor series and parallel connections are quite opposite. So 11th question, what is the equivalent inductance from the figure 5? This is the figure 5, so find the equivalent inductance of this, and you know, find the equivalent inductance of this circuit. What is the equivalent capacitance from the given figure? You need to find the equivalent capacitance. So you can see the 4 microfarad, 12 microfarad, 3 microfarad, and all these are connected, and find how they are connected, whether they are connected in series or parallel, and identify the type of connection and find the equivalent capacitance. The same way, what is the equivalent resistance in this case? Although you may not be visible, I'll also give you that again. Circuit. I'll also send you that circuit again. So let's get to the 15th question. What is the equivalent resistance from the given circuit? Find the equivalent resistance across A and B. Let's see how many of you can do it. Check whether these given resistors are connected in series or parallel. This is not just a series circuit or a parallel circuit, but it's a combination of series and parallel circuit. You need to identify whether they are connected in series or parallel, and then find the equivalent resistance. Now find the inductance of a coil through which flows a current of 0.2 amperes and energy of 0.2 joules. You need to find the inductance. Next, a capacitance having a capacitor having a capacitance of 4 microfarad is charged to a voltage of 1000 volts. Calculate the energy stored. You need to find the energy stored in the capacitor. So these are the answers for your question. I hope you have got habituated to write the answers for each and every question, and check whether your questions are your answers are correct to the corresponding questions, and if there is anything wrong, so just go back and look at the video once again, so that you will know the concept of capacitance and inductance much better, and also their types of connections, series and parallel connections, their voltage and current expressions, and the energy stored by an inductor and capacitor. You have to understand that the capacitor stores energy in the form of electric field, and an inductor stores energy in the form of magnetic field. So these are the answers for the questions, the quiz. End of the lecture 2. Thank you. If you have any queries, you can ping me on my number. I'll be available. Even if I don't respond, probably whenever I'm free, I could probably get back to you and clear your doubts. Thank you.